I'm going to briefly describe this interactive simulation that models a simplified version of batch distillation. The idea is we start with a liquid and we add heat, and then the vapor is condensed and collected. So the first flask collect in this case 0.13 moles, and the mole fraction of component one is 0.73. The next one collected, the mole fraction has decreased because we've evaporated the more volatile component. And so this is just to demonstrate how the temperature changes as we carry out batch distillation. Now, keep in mind, in a real system, we most likely are going to have a column here, and we're going to get much better separation than I'm showing for this particular case. But I think it helps to visualize by first looking at this simple case. The simulation allows us to use this slider at the top to change the mole fraction we start with. And then the second slider allows us to pick how much evaporates with each flask that we fill. Now, particular example here, it says no azeotrope. We also can select the case where it has azeotrope. And instead of displaying the flask, we can show the XY plot in the behavior and the TXY plot in the behavior as a function of time. So let's look at the actual simulation. So here's the interactive simulation. You can see I can change the initial mole fraction in the still, and I can change how much is going to be evaporated each time I press the play button. So, for example, let me make this so it doesn't take too long. And I press play. And so you'll notice that condensate is enriched in B. And when I do it again, of course, it's not as enriched because I'm depleting B preferentially from the still. But each time I can see. And the other thing to notice on this simulation is that the temperature in the still is increasing as I carry out this distillation. This is for an ideal mixture. And the other thing you'll notice, when it gets to 0.20 moles, it stops. In other words, we don't let the still go dry in this simulation. I could have just as easily looked at the mole fraction, and let me reset first. So again, ideal system, but notice as I collect, I'm decreasing the mole fractions in both the liquid and the vapor phase. But also look at the TXY diagram, and now as I collect, you'll notice the temperature is going up, and that then relates to how these mole fractions change. If I reset, I can also look at the case where we have an azeotrope. So let's look at a maximum boiling point azeotrope. So let's pick conditions where we're not too close to the azeotrope. And now as I press play, you notice the mole fractions for the liquid and the vapor are getting closer together, and the temperature is going up. So I'm approaching the azeotrope, and of course the azeotrope, the liquid, and the vapor phases would have the same composition. We'd get no separation. And finally, we could also look at minimum boiling azeotrope. And now as I press play, again the temperature increases, but notice we're moving away from the azeotrope. So the idea of this simulation is a simplified version of how batch distillation would be carried out, where typically we have a column so we get better separation than we're getting in this simplified version. But hopefully this gives you a good idea of the concepts behind batch distillation.